Hello and welcome back to my kitchen. Today we're going to prepare these delicious pumpkin candies. Don't they look delicious? These are the same types of candies that you find in Mexican grocery stores. And today I'm going to show you a step-by-step tutorial on how to prepare them. Let's start with the recipe. In the last video, we used a pumpkin that weighed approximately 8 pounds. We used half of the pumpkin to prepare pumpkin con piloncillo, and the other half, which is the one we're using today, we're going to use it to prepare the pumpkin candies. First, we're going to cut the pumpkin into small pieces like these, and with a paring knife, we're going to trim off the outer skin of the pumpkin. Once it's nice and clean, we're going to flip it over, and we're going to trim off the fibers of the pumpkin. Trimming off the fibers is completely optional, but I prefer to have a nice clean piece of candy like this. And we're going to repeat the process with the remainder of the pieces until we're all done. Once all the pieces are nice and clean, we're going to place them in a bowl. To help crystallize the pumpkin, we're going to soak the pumpkin in 4 ounces of hydrated lime. But before we add it into the bowl, we're going to transfer the hydrated lime into a measuring cup. And we're going to add about 1 to 2 cups of hot water. Mix until the hydrated lime is completely dissolved, then pour it over the pumpkin. Depending on the size of bowl or container that you're using to soak the pumpkin, add more water to where the pumpkin is completely submerged in the water. We're going to cover it and we're going to leave it on the counter soaking for at least 24 hours. No need for refrigeration. During the 24-hour process, the hydrated lime will tend to settle to the bottom. So during the 24-hour process, come back and check on it every once in a while to move it around. I left mine soaking for a little bit over 24 hours, but it's perfectly fine because the longer you let it soak, the better the results. We're going to drain out the water with the hydrated lime, and we're going to give it 2 to 3 good washes, or as many washes as it takes until the water runs clear. For better results, use warm water when rinsing the pumpkin. As you're rinsing the pumpkin, using your hands, rub down the pieces to remove any pieces of residue from the hydrated lime. Repeat the process as many times necessary until the water runs clean. Fill a large stock pot halfway with water, and before we place each one of the pieces into the pot, we're going to run them under clean water and we're going to give them one final rub before placing it in the pot. And we're going to repeat the process with each one of the pieces until they're all clean. We're going to take this outside and we're going to place it on the burner on high heat. And while we wait for the pumpkin to boil in a separate pot, we're going to begin to prepare the rest of the ingredients for the candied pumpkin. You can use a clay pot like this or any other pot of your choice. We're going to start by adding 1 liter of water and 2 to 3 cinnamon sticks. The cinnamon I'm using is very large, so I'm only going to use 1, which makes up for about 2 to 3 sticks of cinnamon. We're also going to add 2 7-ounce cones of piloncillo and 6 cups of granulated sugar. Bring to a boil over high heat and boil for about 20 to 25 minutes or until the piloncillo is completely dissolved. Meanwhile, we're going to check on the pumpkin. Once the water begins to boil, you'll want to boil the pumpkin for no longer than 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, remove it and place it in a bowl so it can cool down a bit. The water with the piloncillo and the sugar has been boiling for about 20 to 25 minutes. The piloncillo is now completely dissolved. Now we're ready to move on to the next step. Before we place the pieces of pumpkin into the pot, using a fork, we're going to make a couple small incisions to the top of the pumpkin. By doing so, it's going to absorb more of the sweetness and it's going to make your dulces de calabaza a lot more flavorful. We're going to repeat the process with the rest of the pieces until we're all done. Then we're going to cover it and we're going to boil over medium heat for 1 hour. During the process, we're going to come back and check on it every once in a while to move them around. The cooking process can take anywhere from 2 to 2.5 hours. It truly is a long process to prepare these candies, but they are very well worth it. And as you can see, after an hour of cooking time, the candies are still intact. Soaking them in the hydrated lime is what keeps them intact. We're going to cook for an additional hour over low heat without the lid. After 1 hour of cooking time, the sugar water has become a little bit more thicker. Now we're just going to remove the pumpkin and we're going to place them on a cookie sheet. We're going to continue to boil the water for another 30 minutes to an hour on low heat or until it turns into a thick syrup-like consistency. Once it reaches this point, we're going to add the pumpkin back into the syrup and we're going to boil for about 10 to 15 minutes in the syrup. This is completely optional. You can enjoy them just as they were, but doing this adds another layer of sweetness and it makes them extra crystallized. With the amount of sugar and piloncillo that I used, it gave them just the right amount of sweetness. But if you prefer yours more on the sweeter side, you can add more sugar or piloncillo. Then we're going to remove them once again and we're going to place them on a cookie sheet. Once the candy has cooled down, your candies are ready to enjoy. Now the true test is how they look on the inside. So let's break one open to see what it looks on the inside. And look at that, just as I suspected, they came out perfect. Now for my favorite part, the taste test. Just as I suspected, these came out amazingly delicious. I hope you give this recipe a try. And if you do, let me know how you like it in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, share with your friends and family so they don't miss out on future recipes like this one. Thank you so much for allowing me in your home today to share this delicious recipe. And I hope to see you in our next video with a different recipe.